So hi all, today we will see this question, subset sums. This question was asked yesterday in the POD. So given a list array of n integers, print sums of all subsets in it, output should be printed in increasing order of sums. That is, for any given array, we have to find all of its subset and find the sum of these subsets and simply print them in the ascending order. See, for example, I have an array 2, 3, 5. So, what are the subsets for this array? So, the subset can be empty subset. Then we have the individual elements 2, 3, 5. Then we can form pairs 2, 3, 3, 5. 2, 5, since subset doesn't have to be continuous, and we can take the whole. So how many subsets we got? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That is, for any n, we have total 2 raised to the power n subsets. And in this question, what we have to do, we have to find the sums of all these subsets. So what is the sum for this? 0. What is the sum for this? 2. Sum 3. Sum 5. Sum 5. 8. For here 7. Here 10. And we have to simply print these in increasing order of the sums. So as in this test case, we can see there were 5, 2, 1 and we have total 8 sums. That is 2 raised to the power 3. So see how, first of all, the first step is to generate all the subsets. So how can we generate all the subsets? So to generate all the subsets, see if I have this array 2, 3, 5, then for any element, I have a choice either to consider that element in my current subset or not. So I will make the choice diagram for this. So let's suppose initially I have an empty subset. Now I am at 2 and I have the choice to either include 2 or exclude 2. So if I am including the 2, subset becomes 2, and if I am excluding, this is still the empty subset. Now I have the choice to either include 3 or to exclude 3. If I am including 3, the subset becomes 2, 3, and if I am excluding 3, it remains 2 only. Similarly, for here, I have the choice to include 3 or exclude 3, which is, it becomes 3 and it remains empty subset. Now, I am at this position, 5. So, I have again two choices, either to include 5 or to exclude 5. So, if I am including the 5, subset becomes 2, 3, 5 and otherwise, this remains 2, 3. Similarly, for here, I have two choices, either to include 5, subset becomes 2, 5, otherwise it remains 2. Similarly for here, if I am including, it becomes 3, 5, otherwise it remains 3. Similarly for here, if I add 5, it becomes 5, otherwise this is the empty. So how many did I got? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So that was all that is asked in our question, that we have to generate all the subsets and find the sums of it. Now, if I have to find the sum for it, what can I do? I can maintain one variable sum, which is initialized as 0. Here the sum is 0. And now when I'm including 2, then I will change my sum also to 2. And when I'm excluding 2, the sum remains 0. Now in this step, I'm adding 3, so my sum becomes 5. And here I'm excluding 3, so sum remains 2. Here I am including 3, sum becomes 3. Here I am excluding 3, the sum becomes 0. Now here I am including 5, the sum becomes 5 plus 5, 10. Here I am excluding 5, the sum remains 7, 5. Here I am including 5, the sum becomes 7. Here I am excluding 5, the sum becomes 2. Here I am including 5, sum becomes 8. Here I am excluding 5, sum becomes 3. Here I am including 5, sum becomes 5, and here the sum is 0. So as you can see, we have got all the sums 10, 5, 7, 2, 8, 8, 5, 0, and we have to simply print them in ascending order, which is 0, 2, 5, 5, 8, 7, 8, 8, 10. Okay. So basically what we have done, we have generated all the subsets and we have maintained one pointer sum, which is keeping track for the sum. So basically we have two recursive calls. First recursive call is doing what? This is incrementing my I pointer, that is I am moving to the next element and I am considering that element. So if I am considering that element, I will add that element to my sum. And what the other recursive call is doing, moving ahead, but I'm excluding this element, so the sum remains what it was. Okay, and what is the base condition? I'm stopping when I've traversed the complete array. So if my I becomes n, that is I have completely traversed my array, so I can simply push back my answer to the resultant vector, not answer, basically sum, and then I can simply return the result. Okay, and we have initialized sum with 0, I with 0. So that was all about it, and we will need one vector result which will store our answer. So let us now code it. So see, I have to return a vector. So let us just name that vector as result. And now we will call the function that will solve this task for us. And let me just name it sum. Now see what I have to send this as a parameter. I have to send my given array. I have to send this resultant array to store the result. Then I have to send the current ith element, which is 0. Now what is the size of the array n and what is the sum 0? Initializing sum as 0 and I as 0. Now we have to simply sort this given vector. And then we can simply return this. So here I have void solve. So the arguments are given vector, then we have the resultant vector. We will take it as a reference so that the answer can get stored. Now I have I, then I have the n, the size of the array, and then I have the sum, which is initialized with 0. So first of all, what we do in recursion, we write the base condition. So what is the base condition? If I is equals to n, that is we have completely traversed our array, then we will simply add this sum to our resultant vector and we can return this recursive call. Otherwise, what we have to do, we have to make two recursive calls. First recursive call, I am considering that element, so I will add that to my sum. And the second recursive call, when I am not including that element, so my sum remains same. Let us see. So yeah, the problem is successfully solved. So let us just dry run this test case also. Let us see the dry run for this test case also. So this is 5, 2, 1. Okay, so basically I have 5, 2, 1 as my given array. So initially my subset is empty and my sum is also 0. So now I am at this position, I is equal to 0. So I have two choices, either to include 5 or to exclude 5. So if I am including the 5, subset becomes 5 and the sum will also become 5. And if I am including this, so my sum remains 0. Now I am at this position 2. So I have two options, either to include this 2 or to exclude 2. So if I am including the 2, then my subset becomes 5 and 2 and the sum becomes 7. And if I am excluding the 2, then the subset remains the same and the sum remains the same. Here also I have two choices, either to include 2 or to exclude 2. So if I am including the 2, the sum became 2. And if I am excluding the 2, then sum remains 0. So now I am at this position 1. So again I have two choices, either to consider 1 or not. So if I am considering 1 here, then my sum subset will become 5, 2, 1 and the sum will become 8. And if I am excluding 7, then my subset remains the same and the sum remains the same. Here also I have two options. If I am including 1, sum becomes 6. And if I am excluding 1, then sum remains 5. Here also I have two options. If I am including 1, then sum became 3. And if I am excluding 1, sum remains 2. Here also I have two choices. If I am including 1, sum subset becomes 1 and the sum is 1. And if I am excluding 1, subset remains empty and the sum is 0. So what are the sums that I got was 8, 7, 6, 5, 3, 2, 1, 0. And I have to simply sort this. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7 and 8. So this is my answer. 0, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8. 0, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8. So what is the total time complexity for this? See, at each step, we are growing exponentially. Here we had one branch. Here we have two branches. Here we have four branches. Here we have eight branches. So as we can see, we are just growing exponentially. And for any n, we have total 2 to the power n subsets. So for generating these many, it will take 2 to the power n time complexity. That is okay, and we have to maintain our recursive call stack. That is why it's taking time space complexity. So that was all about this question. If you have any doubts, feel free to comment. Thank you.